terrorism all around the world. We live in a world of impossibilities, it seems. I think about people that I deal with on a daily basis who seem to live in a world of impossibilities. They deal with problems in their homes. They deal with relationships that seem to be fractured and can't hold together. More and more I see trouble in families. And I see parents that cry to me and they say, what can I do with this child? What's going on? Is there any help? And as I look at this story, this resurrection revelation, I want to draw our attention to this God who did this awesome feat that we cannot even comprehend. Jesus showed his followers that he could overcome the impossible. That nothing is impossible with God. Jesus said, with God, all things are possible. And one day Jesus was confronted with a demon-possessed boy, and the boy's father said, if you can do anything, take pity on us and help us. And Jesus said, if you can. Jesus said, everything is possible for him who believes. To believe in the power of God. Now, there are many impossibilities that we seek to look at today. We look at sickness, but you can get well from sickness. We look at financial ruin, but you can overcome that and you can come back. I knew a man one time that had been rich 3 times and broke 3 times. It seemed to be a cycle. He'd make it, he'd lose it, he'd make it, he'd lose it, he'd make it, he'd lose it. And I don't know where he was when he died, whether he'd made it or lost it, but he'd gone through that cycle over and over. But you can recover from financial ruin. You can come back from a broken relationship. I've seen it over and over, people that put their lives back together. You can overcome things. But let me say to you, there is one thing that you cannot overcome through self-will and determination, and that is death. You can't overcome that. There is only one who is able to do that. And that is our God, through his Son, Jesus Christ, who was put in that tomb. He overcame death. That is the final impossibility. We can't even overcome it. As much as we can overcome other things, we can't do that. But God overcame death. Death was defeated in the tomb. When Jesus died on the cross, his sacrificial death paid the price demanded by our holy God. When God's Spirit moved in the cold tomb of death and breathed life into his Son, he was born again. And God overcame death. And so if the ultimate enemy is death, and that death has been defeated by God, and if we believe in God and we accept Christ as our Savior, we too become overcomers of that event that takes place. All of you have lost loved ones. If you're young today, you haven't experienced all that. But all of you have lost them, and there will be those that you will lose. But I want to tell you that there is victory on the other side of the veil. There is victory on the other side of the door. There is an eternal place that all of us will long to be as Christians. And they're the ones that have received it. When I see people struggling and hurting, I think their victory's coming. It's coming. It's there for all of us. And we must look to that in a positive way, because that is the experience that we're going to have with God for all eternity. We need to have faith in the God who can overcome impossibilities. Jesus said, I tell you the truth, if you have faith as small as a mustard seed, you can say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move. Nothing will be impossible for you. And I use that verse a lot. When I'm out walking and trying to lose that mountain that seems to surround me, we need a little acronym. I just say, mountain, you move. Fella told me there's just so much, and I use the term bad, there's just so much bad in the world. He said, what happens is you see somebody lose it, you look down the end of the street, somebody put on some weight, and evidently it was moving back. I don't know if that's true or not. I don't know how scientific that fellow was. But we all have some mountains in our lives that we need to move on. It may be a health issue. It may be a relationship problem. It may be the fact you just need to lose some weight. It may be any of those things. But Jesus says that all things are possible. You can say to that mountain, move. Now, there's things you have to do. And to move those mountains, not only do you have faith that God may speak to you a word that you need to do something in particular to deal with that mountain, that's okay. That doesn't take away from faith. It just means that God is involved with you in that whole process. Jesus is not asking us to have faith in faith itself. He's asking us to have faith in the God that proved himself in this world. He created the world. And offered redemption to the world, and he sustains the world. You may have a dream that seems dead, a goal that's gone, a relationship that is ruined, a child that seems to be a lost cause, or a career that has crashed. But put your trust in God. God will help you to work through all of that in your life. Let me tell you about a little girl named Angela. She was 11 years old, and she was stricken with a debilitating disease involving her nervous system. She was unable to walk, and her movement was restricted in other ways as well. The doctors did not hold out much hope of her ever recovering from this illness. They predicted she'd spend the rest of her life in a wheelchair. They said that a few were able to come back to normal after contracting this disease. The little girl heard those words and she was undaunted. She developed a faith that she was going to walk again someday. She was transferred to a specialized rehabilitation hospital in the San Francisco Bay Area, and the therapist began to work with her physically. And they tried to help her with her ability to walk, to develop muscle and motor skills again. But they also taught her about imaging, about seeing herself walking. And that little girl, Angela, began to envision herself walking, getting out of that bed and walking and going back to school. And one day, as she was straining with all her might to imagine her legs moving again, it seemed as though a miracle happened. The bed moved. It began to move around the room. She screamed out, look what I'm doing. Look, I can do it. I moved. Of course, at this very moment, everyone in the hospital was screaming too and running for cover. People were screaming. Equipment was falling and glass was breaking. You see, it was October the 17th, 1989, at 5:04 in the afternoon when the San Francisco earthquake took place. At 5:05, there were 56,000 baseball fans watching the warm-up for the third game